Fred Imus, come on up.
I know you want to leave me, but I refuse to let you go. If I have to beg, plead for your sympathy, I don't mind, cause you mean that much to me.
Imus in the morning.
Gone, pussy?
I'm in Utica, New York.
Uh-oh.
Here at the, a gorgeous old theater. Looks like it's probably about 100 years old. One of these really ornate, elaborate, gorgeous old, looks like an opera theater, doesn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah, it's beautiful.
Looks like about 100-foot ceiling and all that. Bunch of nice folks here from, please don't holler at me when I'm talking, because I don't want that. We will have you removed from the premises. We're on WXUR, Oldie Fan 2.7. And it's time now, making a trip here with us from the Archdiocese of New York.
Yeah.
Please welcome to the Imus Morning Program, John Cardinal O'Connor. Good morning, Cardinal O'Connor.
Good morning, God bless. Good to be with you heathens and the I-Man here in Utica, New York, Imus Lamar.
Yeah.
Planet Utica, be Jesus.
Yeah.
Please pass along my regards to the lovely Mrs. Imus.
I'll do that.
Otherwise known as the Bride of Schmucky, be Jesus. Look at McCard over there. Look at him, will you? Yeah. Unhappy with the election, are you, McCard?
Huh?
Geez, you couldn't tell. McCord looked like you've been sucking on a lemon these past few days. Geez, get over it, you jackboot-wearing jackass, you. How'd you hurt that shoulder, McCord? Out in Halloween knocking over Jewish tombstones, you barbarian, you Jesus?
No.
Figures McCord's reaction to the devastation in Central America is that we should shore up border patrols, but Jesus, you callous stalk, you. The winning numbers in the New York State lottery is as follows.
That's what we want. That's why you're here.
Congratulations in order to cheesy Chuck Schumer, Amos Lamar.
Yeah.
Senator Putzhead. Thanks to New York's Jewish community rewarding the best friend they ever had by voting for his opponent. Al D'Amato had more yarmulkes than the I-Man has wrinkles, be Jesus. And for what? Maybe instead of bringing home the bacon, D'Amato should have been bringing home the bagels, be Jesus, some damn thing. I think you're sick. Well, I hate to bust the First Lady Hillary Clinton's current bubble, I, Miss Lamar. But just say this. This country wouldn't be the global embarrassment it is if she had been fulfilling her husband's manly needs.
You know, that will be fine. We don't need it to get into that.
All poor William Jefferson wanted was to sleep with the likes of a Mariah Carey. Not Drew Carey, be Jesus. Big-legged beast. Wasn't his fault.
That will be fine. God.
Well, I'd be rooting for the New York Jets over the Bills this weekend, eh, Mr. Lamar?
Well?
Let me just say that our president... Shut up, you heathenches. Let me just say that our president is a lot like Buffalo's quarterback, Doug Flutie. Both Bills are very lucky, very small men who once heard Canada beckon, and who both fake to the right and always throw to the left, be Jesus, flipping phonies.
That would be fine. Guess you'd have to be a football fan to get that one right.
That ends this unfunny metaphorical diatribe, by Mr. Barnes. Your mumbled-mouthed mummy would be Jesus.
That will be fine.
Can't wait to hear the words bus accident and Imus in the same sentence. I tell you that, Imus Lamar. The win four number.
What are the win four numbers?
Let me just say this, Imus Lamar.
Where are the numbers?
People Magazine reporting that just like the I-Man did, media stars Al Roker and Larry King, each about to have wee little babies with their most recent wives.
Yeah.
Larry says he'll name his new boy Chance King, which is appropriate, given the strong chance that his baby might resemble Al Roker's baby, you know what I mean?
No.
Be tested for sickle cell anemia or some damn thing, silly old fool.
No, stop.
I'll tell you what, Mr. Marr, I'm about fed up. Tired of suffering dumb bastards like yourselves. But Cardinal's written a little limerick, Mr. Marr. How are the lungs doing,
I was just coughing. I have the flu. God.
Shut up.
Let's hear your little limerick.
Now we have a governor who's known for ass-kicking, a president who's lauded for choking his chicken. Our Congress has Conyers, Gingrich, and Frank, the space shuttle, old farts, and a Japanese skank. We're all making money and selling our souls. The I-Man still breathes, the eternal a-hole. So give me the Nikes and Halley's Comet, and no more of Imus's verbal vomit, be Jesus. Go on ahead, schmuckies. Which doesn't belong and why?
This is my favorite part. Which doesn't belong and why?
Which doesn't belong and why?
All right.
A, Thomas Jefferson.
Thomas Jefferson.
B, Bill Clinton.
Bill Clinton.
C, Imus in the morning. Which doesn't belong and why?
Well, obviously, Imus in the morning.
Wrong, you wrinkled up old dingleberry, you be Jesus. While all three have gotten jiggy with black hose and have littered the landscape with mulatto babies,
yes.
The answer is B, Bill Clinton doesn't belong because unlike the other two, Clinton's hoes were born after the Emancipation Proclamation, be Jesus. They never picked no cotton, eh, Mr. Lamar. God bless us and save us a whole lot. He's have a lovely weekend, be Jesus. Go ahead.
John Cardinal O'Connor here.
Respect you. Move along.
I'm Mr. the Morning Program. Okay. Fred Imus coming up.
ready for me to broadcast it revealed another way. Primus live from Santa Fe. Sponsored by Jeep. Well, be no creep, go and get that Jeep. Good morning, Fred.
Be no creep, get a Jeep.
Well.
How you doing?
You don't care how we're doing at all here. Well, it's been a rough morning, hasn't it, Charles?
Yes, it has.
Been a very rough morning, son. But things are straightened out now, so.
What? Technical problems?
Some, yeah.
Yeah.
Yesterday out at the ranch, they turned over a cement truck. Is that what happened, Fred?
Yeah.
How big was the cement truck?
Well, it's one of those big ones, you know, that holds 80,000 pounds of cement.
Uh-huh.
Some made a fairly big mess out there. Mm-hmm.
Is this something that the kids will have to clean up when they go out there?
Oh, no, that's going to be cleaned up today because they spilled diesel fuel and oil out there, so they got to take that. They get, not only get the cement, but get the dirt off the property.
Yeah.
So I got to go out there today and make sure they do that. You know, they don't try to dump it somewhere.
Well,
I guarantee you that's what they'll try to do if you don't stand there and watch them.
Mm-hmm. Thank you for sharing that with us. Fred doesn't sound like he's in a great humor.
I'm in a great humor.
Are you? So, you ready to pick your football games?
Sure.
Okay, the Jets and Bills. That's a huge game. It's the only game this week that really amounts to anything. The rest of the games are not even worth talking about.
Well, when Flutie's playing, it's just like Joe Montana.
Mm-hmm.
You can't pick against him, you know? Right. I mean, the Bills are going to lose probably a couple games. But,
you are such a phony, you know that?
No, I said this before Flutie ever took a snap for Buffalo. Yeah. I mean, I'm not one of these guys that just jumped on the Flutie bandwagon.
Right.
But when he's in there, you can watch the rest of the team. Those guys all think they have a chance to win.
I will give you $1 million in cash if you can name the Canadian football team that he played for. Well, I rest my case.
Well, I could think, you know, I know, because I've watched him play up there in different games. I just can't, off the top of my head, I just can't think of the name of the team.
Yeah.
Just give me a hint.
Ottawa. What's their nickname? The Ottawa?
Argonauts, isn't it?
Argonauts, yeah.
The Ottawa what?
Whalers.
No, not Whalers, Fred.
Packers. Ottawa
not
Packers.
Packers.
The Ottawa
Rough
Redskins.
No, no. The Ottawa Rough Riders.
Ottawa Rams. That's
no,
what it was. The Ottawa Rams.
Anyway, what's your point about Flutie now?
Well, my point is that when he's in the game, the rest of the team thinks they have a chance to win any game.
Right.
That's what Buffalo, the whole team's playing better. It's not just Flutie.
Right.
When he's in there, they all, I mean, you can watch the team, and they're all playing better.
So the Jets are favored by 3.5, Fred.
Well, the Jets could win that game, but I bet.
Well, who are
I
you
would,
picking?
I'm picking Buffalo. Oh,
okay.
But it's the best game to watch this weekend. I mean, there's no other games that... I'll tell you another good game. Seahawks and Chiefs could be a good game.
Who are you picking in that game?
I'm picking the Seahawks.
You know, we're here in central New York, Utica, which is near Syracuse.
Yeah.
There's probably about 1,500 people here this morning. I notice many of them are wearing Auto Body Express merchandise. And, of course, Utica is closer to Buffalo than it would be to...
Yeah, but I didn't pick Buffalo for that reason.
Well, we know better than that, but...
You think I'm some kind of slime ball that just picks what the people want me to pick?
Yeah.
Just depending on where you are?
Exactly.
Yes. Bingo.
That just makes me sick.
Seahawks-Chiefs, who do you like in that game now?
I like the Seahawks. You know, the Kansas City is on a downward spiral.
Okay, I don't think we need a lot of analysis, Fred. Just pick.
Well, then why do I watch this game film and talk to these coaches if you don't want some analysis? What, I'm just wasting my time doing that?
Yes, you are.
Okay, good.
The Patriots and the Falcons, who do you like in that game?
You know, that's a good game.
Okay.
Patriots
are favored by 4.5 points. The game is in Foxborough.
You know, I'm going to pick Atlanta. I'm going to go out on a limb and pick Atlanta in that game.
Okay. Who did you pick in the Seahawks-Chiefs game? The Seahawks.
Seahawks.
All right, how about the Raiders and the... Well, I don't care about that. How about the Bears and the Rams?
Rams will win that game.
Okay. So Fred's picking all underdogs. How about the 49ers and the Panthers?
49ers should bounce back.
They're favored by 2 touchdowns, Fred.
I guess somebody thinks they're really going to bounce back.
Yeah.
How are your quail doing, by the way?
They're doing very well. I'm working on another little pen outside for these.
Mm-hmm.
Because I don't want to...
I know.
Because I have my 2 adult quail. They're California quail and 1 pen.
Right.
And then these are Bob White quail. And I don't want any intermarriage thing going on with them, you know?
Right. With the quail.
Yeah, so I have to, like, separate them.
Right.
I don't want to come up with some aberration, you know?
Right, some...
Plus, I need a lot of room, you know, so... You know that big dog run I built that I ever put a dog in?
Yes.
Well, I built that for some reason, you know. I just didn't know at the time I built it.
Right.
But actually, I built it for quail.
You did?
Yeah, I thought I built it for a dog, but obviously that wasn't the case.
Yeah.
There's just another example of being a visionary.
So, don't you have to put a top on it to keep the quail from flying away?
Yeah, we're going to put a top on it, just kind of a chicken wire situation. Where...
Jesus, God, I mean, they park a bunch of junk cars around in your...
Well, I'll probably turn a car over in the yard and take the wheels off my trailer and park it up here.
We have to go. I love you. I'll call you later, Fred.
I got to smoke another cigarette, try to get this thing to go down. That's the only reason I smoke is once in a while I got to light one up and touch it and burn the head of it to get it to go down.
Now, that'll be fine. Fred's sponsored by Jeep. Thanks, Fred.
You want to hear something? Well, you want to hear me drive a nail in with it?
No, I don't. No, we don't.
But I think I'm going to smoke another packet today.
It's 19 now.
Get up to four packs, man.
Here's Belva from Birmingham, Alabama. Why are so many people calling from Birmingham, Alabama, Belva?
The only thing I can tell you is I am irritated as hell at you. Why are you so bitter? Why do you talk to the people like you do?
Well, what the hell are you getting up at 5 o'clock in the morning? Why don't you watch the Today Show?
I did until you came on, but I find you interesting, and I'm trying to analyze you because you have problems.
I don't have any problems, lady. Well, I have indoor plumbing.
If your radio sounds funny in the morning, you're listening to Imus in the morning.
You got something wrong because you're trying to keep up with Deidre, and baby, you're not going to be able to.
Well, what was I supposed to do? I fell in love with a woman. I couldn't help it if she was a teenager.
Live alone.
I tried that. I lived alone for 15 years.
You're so lost without Chuck this morning, you don't know what to do.
Well, you know one of the reasons I'm talking to you?
Because Chuck's not there.
Program. It is now 6 minutes to the hour.
Fellas, I'm ready to get up and do my thing. I want to get into it, man, you know. Like a sex machine, man. Moving, doing it, you know. Can I count it off? 1, 2, 3, 4.
Imus in the morning.
Tonight it is.
Imus in the morning 2024 rolls on.
The NBA season is dying. Good morning. Mike Braywood Sports saying hi to the I-Man fans in Utica, a city that should have their own NBA franchise. God. NBA lockout now in its 129th day, and there's no end in sight. And the players are starting to feel it, not just financially, but according to union chief Billy Hunter, the players feeling low self-esteem, and it's affecting them sexually. Hunter explained how the low self-esteem problem trickles down.
The flooding of blood into that area. If it can't get into the penis, it diminishes the erection.
Despite the lack of erections, Hunter says the players are still unified in hoping to break the owners. Turning to the NFL, big game this week, the Bills and the Jets, both 5-3, both red hot. Buffalo's Doug Flutie has been sensational since taking over for the injured Rob Johnson. The diminutive veteran has led the Bills to 4 straight wins. The miniature quarterback was asked if he's shocked at his success.
Yeah.
Bills traveling now to the Meadowlands. An interesting stat on Flutie. He's the 39th highest paid player on his own team. Makes over about $300,000, and that's it. Quite a bargain for the Buffalo Bills.
I'll be darned.
In the NHL, Islanders led 3-0 after 12 minutes last night at home against Carolina. Islanders lost the game 6-3 at home last night against Carolina. 6 unanswered goals. Here's Islander coach Mike Milbury.
If anybody in the room is satisfied with it, if they shouldn't be in the room. It sucked. We made mistakes that cost us the hockey game. And to be satisfied with it would be tantamount to idiocy.
I'd say he handled the loss fairly well, wouldn't you? Islanders, despite the loss, have clinched a playoff berth. And that's sports. I'm Mike Green.
Thank you very much, Mike. It's 9 o'clock here in
Utica, and this is WFAN in New York. It's time for the news. Here with Anna Charles McCoy. Good morning, Charles.
Morning, I-Man. Some of the developments.
Every 20 minutes, Bobby Slur. WFAN 2020 Sports.
If you love NFL football, then spend your time with us every Sunday here on The Fan. Sports Radio 66, WFAN New York.
623 on The Fan. With reports every 20 minutes, I'm Joe Tolleson, WFAN 2020 Sports.
It's a big AFC East matchup as the Jets host the Buffalo Bills tomorrow at the Meadowlands. Game time is 4:15 with Jets kickoff at 3 here on The Fan. Sports Radio 66, WFAN New York.
It's open house.
Primus in the morning, 2020 Sports. Let's go to the audio tape.
Testaverde, play action. He's got Baxter wide open for a moment. Now throws in the end zone. Touchdown! Touchdown to Keyshawn Johnson, running the post. And a perfect throw by Testaverde.
Vinny and the Jets getting it done.
That was a great pass, man. Just tight little. Did you see that?
Good morning, Mike Freeman Sports.
Yep.
Howard David, the call. This sportscast sponsored by Flutie Flakes, the hot new breakfast cereal named after the undefeated... Oops. This sportscast actually sponsored by Connecticut Limo. When you gotta fly, you gotta call Connecticut Limo. Jets pummel the Bills, 34-12 of the Meadowlands. It was a matchup of the comeback kids at quarterback. Vinny Testaverde of the Jets, 3 touchdowns. Doug Flutie of the Bills, 2 interceptions. What did Flutie think of the Jets?
You know, we think we can match up with them physically, and we think we can do some things.
What game was he watching?
Well,
not the one Bill Parcells was, but Parcells made sure he brought everyone back down to earth when someone asked him what this meant to the Jets.
He tells me that we're 6-3. And that's all it tells me. Uh-huh. I've been down this block before, boys. I mean, they're not sending any 2 dozen roses over here today, and I'm not. If they do, I'm going to send them back.
That's it.
How about a box of chocolates?
Let's not get carried away. And then New England, how did they lose to Atlanta 41-10?
That's right. They were also tied going into yesterday's action, but the Falcons just destroyed them up in Foxborough. Drew Bledsoe was sacked 46 times. And Bledsoe tried to take the blame.
If we let him play like this, you don't have to look any farther than me. We play a quarterback in this league. It's your responsibility to get your team in the end zone. You know, and we didn't get it done.
Did they take him out at some point?
I don't know. We didn't get it done, though. You notice he says,
don't you have DirecTV?
No.
You don't?
No.
You don't have DirecTV and you don't have the football package and you're a sportscaster. And not only a sportscaster, you're a play-by-play guy. You're telling me you don't have DirecTV?
What's that?
Oh, I don't. When is your birthday?
In May.
I'm buying you DirecTV for your birthday.
Well, all right.
I can't understand. You don't have DirecTV?
No.
You don't have the football package?
No.
You're not a man.
Well, I tend to disagree with that.
I mean, not even Charles has it.
What can I tell you? I want to watch the Jets and the Giants.
Well, I mean...
Yeah, but you've got to be...
I mean, you could have watched the end of that Carolina-San Francisco game, man. That
yes,
was a great game.
I could have. I should get it. You're right.
I mean, I don't know what your deal is.
I can't revolve my life around the NFL. I have 3 children on Sundays that I need to spend some time with.
Well.
Well, what?
Oh, well, that's very weak.
It's true.
By the way, can any of your kids speak French yet, like Wyatt?
Well, not
apparently not,
really.
I guess. Okay, well,
I can't say I love you, Daddy.
I can almost say I hate Uncle Bernie. Wyatt already says that. He's a college student.
Where's his hair? That's what they can say.
He says it in French.
He said, Daddy, how come I have more hair than Uncle Bernie?
I have plenty of hair, kid.
Whereas Bledsoe physically and possibly cannot say that I have to do better.
Well, fine. Leave him alone.
Not
He's
the
a good
case.
Quarterback.
Not the case for Lions coach Bobby Ross. At least Bledsoe tried to take some of the blame. Ross's team lost 10-9 to the Eagles in Philly. Coaches will always say the buck stops here. I accept responsibility, but not old Bobby Ross of the Lions.
I'm ticked off. I take the blame. I get all the damn criticism. People are hammering me. I'm a good coach. I know what the heck's supposed to be done, and I know what's supposed to be gotten done.
There you go.
I'm not going to second-guess myself one time. That was terrible what happened out there today with us. You think I coached that stuff?
Get back the money.
Well, maybe you had better have a conversation with your team members because there appears to be a communication lapse here. Isn't there?
not even hinting at taking responsibility.
Well, I like that. That's our kind of guy.
Darn right.
You know? What else going on?
As the Lions now 2-7, Giants, tough loss to the Cowboys 16-6. What did Jim Fossil have to say? Well, you have to tune in this Saturday to Game Day New York and find out what he thinks now of his team out of it for the rest of the season.
Ooh.
Have to do the show in the nude now to get people to watch the rest of the way. Giants are now 3-6.
You're not under the illusion that anybody has been watching your show.
We know for a fact that there are at least 9 season ticket holders that watch every week.
Mike does one of the million football shows in the country.
Right.
On Saturday night in New York.
It's not just one of a million. It's special.
With the coach of the New York Giants, who clearly does not have a clue. So
none.
Loser.
Yeah.
He was coach of the year last year.
Well, it's not going to be this year.
What's
is
he
it?
Doing at this?
You never know.
What have you done for me lately?
Yeah. What else going on?
It's a marathon. It's not a sprint.
What's the game tonight, by the way?
Game tonight, Packers and Steelers on the frozen tundra.
Who won the Tennessee-Tampa Bay game last
Tennessee
night?
Tennessee comes back and beats
in
the
Pittsburgh
Buccaneers today. In Tampa, 31-20.
Mm-hmm. There you go. The game's in Pittsburgh, Bernie informs me.
Is it really?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, Bernie should know.
Oh, you didn't hear about the cold snap? I know, because the parking lot attendant went out to the game this weekend.
We have a frozen tundra.
Okay, have direct TV.
What does it say? Pittsburgh at Green Bay.
That's wrong. No, it is in Pittsburgh. Mac, the parking lot attendant, our man.
Right.
He went to the game.
Yep.
The game is tonight.
Right, in Pittsburgh.
Uh-huh.
But I didn't say it was in Green Bay. I said it was on the frozen tundra.
He's already left?
Yes.
Yeah. Mac's already left.
Yeah.
Who's at the parking lot?
I don't know.
Some new guy.
I don't know.
That isn't
some crack dealer. He's afraid to come out of the booth. Right. Mm-hmm.
That will be $10 today.
Where are we with the NBA thing? No talks scheduled. Doesn't look good. Anything else going on?
In fact,
Jeff Gordon won the Napa 500. Race started in the afternoon, ended after 11 o'clock Eastern time, and Gordon won. 13th win of the season, ties Richard Petty for single-season victories.
Unbelievable.
Well, they only have about 30-some car races every year, right?
Yeah. A boy can race.
And this guy has won 13 of them?
Well,
Ray Abraham and the crew of his, they got the car running good, Joe. They got the car running good. They get her set up right for these tracks. Well, man, the driver is very important, but, I mean, old Ray and those boys got the car set up good. They said, don't they?
How's it running?
Running good. Running real good. It's a quarter till the hour here on the Iverson Morning Program. Is there anything else, Mike?
That's it.
Okay. David Ramnicki, editor of The New Yorker, who has written yet another book here, which we think is a mistake, frankly, now that we got to thinking about it.
Yeah.
If the first book you write wins the Pulitzer Prize,
out of the chute, that's
just
enough.
Just say, well, that's fine.
Thank you very much.
Thanks.
Shows what I can do.
Now,
and that's it.
Next, the ball's in your court now.
Exactly. God. But no.
So, anyway.
We have to get hoggy.
No, so now we're going to try to, taking another run at something here. The only thing he might possibly win, and I'm not even sure of that yet. I don't even know whether he's going to get nominated or not. He might possibly get an IMUS American Book Award nomination, but we don't even know about that.
Oh, no, that's very much up in the air.
So that's clearly up in the air.
Certainly.
So that's, if you win the Pulitzer if you win the Pulitzer, and then the next thing you win is the...
Why you would want to place your... fine reputation at this point in that kind of jeopardy, who knows?
That's beyond me.
Not good judgment.
No. Boomer Esiason from Monday Night Football, he's coming up, and we'll find out if Boomer knows where the game is. Won't we?
Yes.
Be interesting.
Yeah.
And then Fred Imus from Santa Fe. Fred will be coming up, and we'll talk to him about that. The new salsa jars, Fred's Southwest Salsa, which is fabulous. Ben, I'm telling you. It's so good. It's your brother's stuff. What's he going to say? Well, okay, go try it. The new jars are available at all Stop and Shop stores, Shaw's, A&P, Superfood Marts, Walbaum's, Big Y Supermarkets. In the Tri-State area, you can find it at A&P, Walbaum's, Grand Union Supermarkets. Also in Philadelphia, you can find it at all Superfest Supermarkets. You go in and look for the Turquoise Buffalo. And it says, Fred, I'm a Southwest Salsa, and it's thick and chunky, made from all natural ingredients. Comes in medium, mild, and hot. And if you can't find it any place, you can order it from Fred at the Alibot Express, and they open in about 10 minutes out there in Santa Fe.
Great.
And you can get gift packs of it for the holidays, or maybe you just want some yourself.
They're nifty as they can be.
1-800-272-1957. And while you're at it, order one of these black tornado jackets and say, throw in, Fred. I saw your brother told me he was wearing this red... Buffalo polo shirt.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a great polo shirt, not one of those cheap ones like you could get someplace else. It's a great polo shirt. The collar stands up and stays up. And
heavy.
Heavy. And say, I want a red polo shirt, Buffalo polo shirt, and a black tornado jacket with the red buffalo. Please send that and the salsa.
Man, are you ready or what?
1-800-272-1957. Say, put it all in a big gift pack for Xmas for me, Fred, would you please? So,
do that for me, Fred.
Yeah. The Autobody Express is sponsored by Nikon, which is a camera that will take the world's greatest pictures, yours. That counts, that's right. 12 minutes till the hour here on the IMS Morning Program. And, man, this whole thing when Newt went down so fast, it just...
Well, here's PC Modem.
It's about summertime. I'm talking about West Side Story. It's before my time. Police sweat me like the sharks and the jets because I do what I do, so they wanna get me. If you let me, I'll explain the game, clear my name, and show you ain't a damn thing changed. So don't criticize the way that I parlay. This ain't Broadway. We learned it the hard way.
I miss in the morning.
In more than 70 countries.
WFAN 20.
We've got over $25,000 in cash to give away on The Fan this fall. Just listen for your chance to win when we play the WFAN Double Play Sports Celebrity of the Day game on The Fan, Sports Radio 66, WFAN New York.
Staying in shape.
This is John Minko, WFAN 20.
Follow the Yankees all season long on The Fan, Sports Radio 66, WFAN New York.
side of town, Georgia boy was big and round, and his mom and dad thought they were being cute. 'Cause even though he was their pride and joy, they christened him unlike all the other boys. I tell ya, life ain't easy when your name is Newt. Dedicated his life to the GOP. Wanted to be speaker since the age of three, dreaming one day he'd wield power absolute. And he's always been somewhat of a partisan, though he'd been saddled with a sister who's a lesbian. It never did come easy for a boy named Newt. He learned how to add and how to divide, married his math teacher and multiplied, but when he went to subtract himself as a matter of course, it was slimy and low rent, the media said, to visit her in her hospital bed to get her to grade his paper for a divorce. It took almost half a century to get Republicans back in the majority, and when they did, Newt complained that the president was dissolute. And though nobody believed him when he said he didn't do it, Bubba did get a BJ, but the one who really blew it was the fat guy in the house who they called Newt. He preached the American trust was breached and that Bubba was a slime ball who should be impeached, but the last election showed nobody cared a whit. And you know that was a harbinger of doom, so when Judas, his Brutus, Bob Livingston, I presume, challenged the speaker, he said, "My name is Newt. How do you do? You can't fire me. I quit." Now the party's got to try to do some damage control, because Newt didn't listen to the opinion polls, and as a result, he got covered in donkey feces. So in the house, there's total pandemonium, because going into the next millennium, the elephant is now an endangered species. Contract with America was his claim to fame, but now his lame name is besmirched by shame. So if I ever have a son, I think I'm going to name him Strom or Jesse, any damn thing but Newt.
Rush Limbaugh. On the I'm a Sunday Morning program, speaking of House, outgoing House Speaker Newt Gingrich, who is keeping quiet about his future planning. He didn't talk about him at length in a speech last night before the GOPAC organization, the Republican group he once headed, though he did say, this is a quote, "There are many..."
Ezekiel 25.
What's the hour?
Now wait a minute.
I'm a in the morning.
Your friends at A4.
And a boy named Newt. He came into the world from the right side of town. Georgia boy who was big and round, and his mom and dad thought they were being cute. 'Cause even though he was their pride and joy, they christened him unlike all the other boys. I tell ya, life ain't easy when your name is Newt. Dedicated his life to the GOP. Wanted to be speaker since the age of three, dreaming one day he'd wield power absolute. And he's always been somewhat of a partisan, though he'd been saddled with a sister who's a lesbian. It never did come easy for a boy named Newt. He learned how to add and how to divide, married his math teacher and multiplied, but when he went to subtract himself as a matter of course, it was slimy and low rent, the media said, to visit her in her hospital bed to get her to grade his paper for a divorce. It took almost half a century to get Republicans back in the majority, and when they did, Newt complained that the president was dissolute. And though nobody believed him when he said he didn't do it, Bubba did get a BJ, but the one who really blew it was the fat guy in the house who they called Newt. Preached the American trust was breached, and that Bubba was a slime ball who should be impeached, but the last election showed nobody cared a whit. And you know that was a harbinger of doom, so when Judas, his Brutus, Bob Livingston, I presume, challenged the speaker, he said, "My name is Newt. How do you do? You can't fire me. I quit." Party's got to try to do some damage control, because Newt didn't listen to the opinion polls, and as a result, he got covered in donkey feces. So in the house, there's total pandemonium, because going into the next millennium, the elephant is now an endangered species. Contract with America was his claim to fame, but now his lame name is besmirched by shame. So if I ever have a son, I think I'm going to name him
Strom or Jesse, any damn thing but Newt.
I Miss in the Morning 2024 rolls on.
A round of applause for the American League Rookie of the Year. Good morning, Mike Breen with sports. Oakland A's outfielder Ben Grieve is the American League Rookie of the Year. Hit 288 with 18 home runs and was asked after winning, is this the biggest thrill of his baseball career?
It's kind of actually not that as big as a deal as it would normally would be.
All right, be that way. But Grieve did hope that the award could catapult him.
You look at those guys that have won in the past and the careers that they've had. If I can do anything like that, then I'll be happy.
Careers like other rookies of the year, like Steve Howe, suspended 7 times for drug abuse. Wow. Pete Rose, suspended for life for betting on baseball. Tax evasion and Willie McCovey. Now the latest, we understand, on Tom Seaver and embezzlement charges, which we're just finding out details on.
No. That's, we're just jerking your chain. There's no Tom Seaver. What's wrong with you? You can't report stuff that we...
Well, I'm going to find get to the bottom of this story.
There's no truth
to this one, babe.
No, there's not.
God almighty.
God, what an idiot. Just discount that.
I understand there's drugs involved.
No, there's not any drugs. There's nothing involved with Tom Seaver.
I normally don't like to speculate, but...
God, you're an idiot.
Let me just say I'm not surprised.
God, what a moron.
Nope. Kansas City Chiefs have lost 4 in a row. They'd have to play the undefeated Denver Broncos on Monday night. So Coach Marty Schottenheimer made this announcement yesterday.
Elvis Gerbach is the quarterback of the future of the Kansas City Chiefs. I have no doubt about that.
Uh-huh.
None whatsoever.
Right.
Rich Gannon is the quarterback for the Denver Broncos.
So Elvis is my man, but he sucks right now, so Gannon's going to play against the Broncos.
That's it.
And well, if I were, I mean, the Kansas City Chiefs, it's time for Marty to go. Just get rid of him. Him and his dopey brother, get him out of there.
He's got that Parcells podium pounding down.
They're not going to go to the Super Bowl ever with him as the head coach. He can get him in the playoffs, which he did with the Browns. I mean, he's just
ain't going to get the Lombardi.
No, he's just not happening.
When Dawson can come back and quarterback, they ain't going nowhere.
No, they're just not. It's not going to happen. Yeah. We'd like him to. We like the Kansas City Chiefs. Have any close friends on the team?
Sure.
One. But, I mean, it's not happening. And Marty is not happening.
No, nothing up top. Come on. Out. Please.
Just get out.
4 in a row they've lost and now played Denver.
We have some sniveling little twerp general manager at our hideous affiliate in L.A.,
all righty,
KLAC, who's decided now to attack the I-Man. Is that what you're calling about, Norm? On line one, Lou?
Yes, sir.
Is that what you're calling about?
Yes, sir. The man says, quote, she's, I've been trying to get Imus off the air since I got here last year.
Well, guess what? We've been trying to get off that dirtbag hideous radio station. And we don't have any control over the stations they put us on around the country.
And, I understand.
And I'm sure KLAC is fine, but it's a big band station playing Lalo Schifrin and Perry Como records. And this punk, Ed Kramp, who's the vice president of KLAC and was shooting his mouth off in a newspaper yesterday.
He's a buffoon.
Yeah. He said, I think he's very talented, but not a good match with KLAC or Los Angeles. Well, Ed, you sniveling little twerp, we'll find out, won't we, when we go over to KRLA and kick your ass all over L.A.
Absolutely.
And we'll find out. We'll find out who lasts longer in L.A., Ed, me or you.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm with you.
So Ed Kramp, a sniveling little twerp who couldn't get a job with CBS Radio, so he's now working for these dirtbags. And, you know, what Ed should have done is kept his mouth shut and simply said, we're going to change formats. And Mimus is going to KLA, and good luck, and we hope everything works out.
What happens instead?
But no, we have a little twerp, a little gnat, a little radio gnat, who decides to shoot his mouth off and get his one little moment of glory in a newspaper. Well, guess what? He gets his one little shot yesterday. I'll never forget it, ever.
That's all.
I will never forget it. I mean, Charlie Warner used to be the GM dirtbag who we would disparage all of the time, remember? How far back does that go? 1977.
Will it ever be forgotten?
That's how long? 21 years ago that goes, and I still haven't forgotten about it. So Ed Kramp, K-R-A-M-P-F, this little punk is going to be the same situation.
Right.
Ed, just keep your mouth shut.
You
good luck with your radio station. You know, get Lalo Schifrin and Benny Goodman and all of them and have your big segues and leave me alone.
Mr. Evans.
We'll go over to KRLA just the second weekend and kick your ass all over L.A.
You made me cry when you said goodbye.
Thank you.
wait for the I-Man and crew to descend upon it.
Obviously, we're all going to be paying attention to what happens with Bernie.
And of course, referring to Bernard McGurk going to CNN tomorrow during the Iverson in the Morning show.
God, you are just...
God,
you're so lame, it makes my... You know, it just makes me... It makes my skin...
Can I continue?
No.
Come on.
All right, go ahead.
NBA Players Association had a meeting yesterday. Their message, they're still united. Yay. Here's union spokesperson, actually union president, Patrick Ewing, who told the press what happened at the meeting.
Just bringing everybody in, briefing them on what's going on. The NBA have given the teams the right to call all the players and try to give them their side of things. And all we're going to do is bring them in and make sure that they understand and know, you know, what we've been doing.
Ewing says he's not sure what they're doing, but they still explain it nonetheless.
Well, sure. Tell him.
Yeah. 11 till the hour now.
Imus in the morning.
Nicotrol. Now there's a totally new system your doctor can prescribe that can help you control your cravings and quit smoking a Nicotrol inhaler. The Nicotrol inhaler gives you the nicotine. Good morning, Hulk.
I'm telling you, brother, you may be able to push around the president, but you're not going to push around Ted Turner, brother. I'm giving you fair warning. Anybody who comes near the CNN building will have to deal with me. I'm not just Whistling Dixie, brother. You think you're angry at Mr. Turner? I'm a crockpot of rage, brother. I got 30 years worth of steroids backed up in my circulatory system. I'm a Mount St. Helens ready to blow. I'm a 60-year-old man with a failed movie career who's still jumping around topless in his underwear to make a buck, brother. I'm begging you to come over here. I'm at a place in my life where I got to resort to running for president with Oprah Winfrey to get any attention. I'm over the hill, brother. I got to take Viagra just to sit up straight. Give me a reason to lateral this anger. I'm waiting for you, brother. I'll be in the lobby. Look for me. I'll be the big, bald, tan guy slapping around Rick Kaplan.
I feel it. I feel all.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Every time I think about you, you've been so good to me.
I'm a in the morning.
Introducing the all-new Infiniti G20.
Every 20 minutes. Rich Ackerman, WFAN, 2020 Sports.
It's Imus in the morning until 10, and then join me, Steve Summers, and Russ Salzburg schmoozing sports until Mike and the Angry Puppy on Sports Radio 66, The Fan, New York.
Hide, 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 because my love.
Classic Rock Station Q104, Dave.
Call them. I'm not going to give you the number, but to figure it out. But I don't want people to have them now, so how pissed off I am about this.
Well, you've got to give them the number.
I'm not giving them anything.
You've decided to do this. You've got to go through with it, so that...
F them.
Let me ask you this, I'm Mr. Lamar.
Yes, Cardinal.
Are you competing with Rob and Larry to see who can get fatter the fastest, be Jesus?
I'm not fat. What are you talking about?
You're wrinkled up old dirigible. You look at you, you fat slob. I'll tell you what, I'm Mr. Lamar.
Yeah.
Wasn't funny 40 years ago, but today, 1,200 hamburgers to go is certainly no joke as far as the eye match concerned. Not the truth, Porky and Lamar. It'll make you sick. Every damn thing will make you sick today, I'm Mr. Lamar.
Mm-hmm.
Understand they're making a movie about former head intern Monica Lewinsky.
Oh, really?
And maybe they could call it Jaws 3. Or waiting to inhale, filthy tramp, Jesus. Gives a mother a semen stain, if you can believe that.
Oh, well,
goddamn mother, be Jesus, what the hell am I missing?
I don't know.
Happy Mother's Day, Kansas City, here I come indeed. What the hell are we supposed to think now when the president asked the nation to come together?
Well,
what a sickening joke.
Idiotic.
Hey. Ask you this, I'm Mr. Lamar.
Sure.
What is the capital of the state of Missouri?
I don't know.
Not only is the I-Man starting to look like Ted Kennedy, he's about as smart as his nephew, JFK Jr., I'll tell you that.
What is the capital of Missouri?
Jefferson City.
Jefferson City, yeah.
That's right, fella.
Okay.
Named after George Jefferson, I think.
Okay.
Well, he's been called, among other things, I, Mr. Lamar, a big creep and a scumbag.
Right.
Believe it or not, I don't mean you. And now Bill Clinton, the first hooligan, is comparing himself to baseball hero Mark McGuire.
Well, that was a stretch, wasn't it?
Well, maybe he's right. Let's see. They both grab their crotches in public places. Both making history with their bats. Both will have at least this winter off. One's called the Sultan of Swat, the other the Sultan of Twat. Be Jesus, God,
no,
forgive
me. No, no,
all the folks and arrogance.
No.
Why that?
Mark McGuire, indeed. I'd give him spiritual counseling, a good kick in his lying nuts. I tell you that, I'm Mr. Lamar.
That will be fine.
Yet any integrity you do what our urine-colored cousins in the Pacific would do if they were in his shoes.
Yes.
Or his shorts. Commit Harry Carey, be Jesus.
That will be fine.
Get him out. Gore is great in 98. Let me ask you this, I'm Mr. Lamar.
Okay.
You have a tan? Was your face just one big liver spot? Sorry, look, the sloppy of the cheese.
Why am I taking all this abuse? What have I done?
Well, it was the idea behind inviting that snotty Calvin Trillin on the show.
I like Mr. Trillin.
It's like inviting your mother to a titty barbecue. He's no fun. The Big Ten numbers.
Good God, we'd finally like to get to some of those.
What's the story behind the ubiquitous colored congressman, Charles Rangel?
I don't
see one of the original singing ink spots, McGee's, or what's he starring? Keep him off TV, eh, Mr. Marg? Whenever they ask him about impeaching Clinton, I half expect him to start clutching his heart and screaming out, Elizabeth, Elizabeth, Jesus. If we impeach him, go back to Harlem, fatso.
I'm gonna be fine.
Which is a belonging why?
Oh, okay, thankfully at the end of this.
Which is a belonging why?
This is my favorite part. Which doesn't belong and why?
All right. A, talk show host Roseanne Barr.
Roseanne Barr.
B, talk show host Rosie O'Donuts.
Rosie O'Donuts.
C, talk show host Imus in the Morn. Which doesn't belong and why?
Well, clearly, Imus in the Morning.
Wrong, bedwetting buffalo buddy, Jesus. And all three of these unfunny fat bitches have been profiled on A&E's biography. Though their success should be a topic on Unsolved Mysteries.
Yes.
The answer is B, Rosie O'Donuts doesn't belong because unlike the other two...
Yeah.
Rosie has never slept with a man, be Jesus. I get the A-Man another chocolate chip muffin over here.
Colonel O'Connor here. Yeah. On the Ivans of the Morning Bird Camp, live from Kansas City.
Now on line 5, Bill from White Plains. Good morning, Bill.
Morning, I-Man.
How are you?
It's Bill from White Plains.
I know that.
I've called you before.
I remember talking to you.
Oh, you don't always remember.
I know that.
Plus, you got other things on your mind.
Yeah.
With that kid coming.
Yes.
Boy, that's a great idea.
Well.
How do you think your son will feel when you show up at his school wearing that cowboy hat and those tight jeans?
I think he probably won't be happy.
The kids will say, hey, Wyatt, I didn't know your dad was Buddy Epson. Boy, the show's been great lately.
Thank you, Bill.
Now that basketball over, Breen's there every day.
Yeah.
He's funny.
He is good.
I love Mike Breen.
I'm sure you do.
I think he's the best part of the show. No offense to Warner. I mean, Warner Wolf is great.
Yeah.
But you need some young blood.
Sure.
Warner's a little long in the tooth, if you get what I mean. Maybe that's a bad choice of words, I mean.
Considering his teeth fell out on television, yes.
He'll be all right from that incident, though. You just grit your gums and you move on. You guys will get on him next time he fills in for Breen.
Well.
But I guess he'll cross that bridge work when he gets to it.
He probably will.
That video of him losing the teeth, that's not the best of the week, though.
No, it's not.
How about that clip of the president shaking hands with the guy whose pants down around his ankles?
Yeah.
Reminded me of those intern interviews you used to conduct. Those were the good old days, huh, man?
Oh, they sure were, Bill.
Boy, they're long gone, huh?
Yes, they are. That pretty much it, Bill?
Good talking to you, man.
On the next South Lawn, the border war between Eritrea and Ethiopia continues, despite Batman's attempts to make peace.
If you two don't stop fighting, I'll do something drastic like go on a hunger strike. Maybe that wouldn't be such a good idea. You guys already look pretty hungry yourselves.
NATO jets fly over Albania and Macedonia in an attempt to intimidate Yugoslav President Slobodan Milosevic.
Oh, yeah, that's really threatening, putting on an air show. Why don't you just send the Blue Angels over to skywrite Milosevic sucks?
Meanwhile, the administration makes it known it wants to extend provisions of the Brady Bill past the November deadline.
I may need a 5-day waiting period to keep me from shooting Charlton Heston in the head.
The independent counsel acknowledges in a magazine interview that he and his aides gave information on the Monica Lewinsky matter to reporters.
What more do I need to discredit this hole? Pictures of him in a garter belt and panties? I don't think they'll be all that hard to find.
Poor little Monica thinks she and Batman still have a future together.
After the photo spread in Vanity Fair, that fat pig thinks she still has a chance? She's crazier than I thought. Hillary before that happens.
And amidst all the turmoil, Batman finally takes his long-awaited trip to China and causes quite a stir as he visits Tiananmen Square.
Attica! Attica! 4 dead in Ohio! Sorry, Zimin, baby, but if I don't make some human rights statement here, all the bleeding heart pussies back home will get bent out of shape. But tell me something. When you ran over all those chinks with the tanks, did they make a squishy sound, or did you just hear their heads pop?
South Lawn, the television equivalent of a sucking chest wound.
Oh, my God! Dude, you killed Charlton Heston.
Hey, Emmanuel, do me a favor. Go drag Ben Hur over to the park, will you?
It was a teenage wedding and the old folks wished him well. You could see that Pierre did truly love the mademoiselle. And now the young monsieur and madame have rung the chapel bell. C'est la vie, say the old folks, it goes to show you never can tell.
I miss in the morning.
Hey, yeah.
With the New York State Lotto numbers, or perhaps the Powerball numbers, here is John Cardinal O'Connor. Good morning, Cardinal O'Connor.
Good morning, God bless.
Feel like I should be wearing overalls and no shoes this morning here on Hee Haw in the Morning. I was in the morning, Jesus.
We'll be fine.
The time's Minnie Pearl coming on, be Jesus. So how's everybody's favorite wrinkled-up old pedophile, I, Mr. Morning?
How would I know?
Let me just say this. When you decide to have your face surgically improved,
yeah,
let me know. No, a couple of great proctologists, me Jesus.
Oh, that's not Turkey necessary.
Burger looking new for shit.
That will be fine.
The winning numbers in the New York State Lottery is as follows.
That's why he's here, exactly.
The daily number.
Yeah.
The hell is it? The daily number, 924.
Okay.
Well, a big God bless to the McCoy family and the new seven lads and lasses I miss in the mark.
Yeah.
Better this happens in Iowa than in India or Africa or some damn place, you know what I mean?
That would be
Am
fine.
Am I right, McCord?
Absolutely, Cardinal. Yeah.
Why don't you get your nose out of the young man's ass for a few minutes so you can see what's going on?
No. We don't need to go
Let
there.
Let me just say this to Bill Clinton and I, Mr. Lamar.
Yes.
Stay the hell away from Veterans Day, Memorial Day celebrations, be Jesus.
Yeah.
It's like O.J. Simpson at a Mother's Day dinner, be Jesus. Make you sick. Why can't Clinton or some damn body throw that aging federal chairman, Alan Greenspan, out of office? The whole damn economy teetering on a man who looks like he walks into walls looking for his skull cap, be Jesus. Get him out!
This is turning into almost a Fred Imus rant, isn't it?
Speaking of that, hey, Mr. Maher, let me ask you this.
All right.
When do most Jewish men stop masturbating?
I don't know, dear.
When their wives pass away.
Come on, you. I mean, we just, why are we having to...
The win phone number.
Well, okay.
2907.
Fine. don't laugh at him.
Hello, Mr. Lamar.
All right, hurry up here.
TV programming continuing its rapid decline.
Yeah.
Your selfie on MSNBC, a disgrace.
Yeah.
Murphy Brown smoking pot to keep him getting nauseous.
Mm-hmm.
Well, maybe that's what your viewers should try doing, be Jesus. Or the young Mrs. Imus should try at bedtime, be Jesus. Stop her from throwing up.
That would be fine.
And in a desperate ratings ploy, Imus Lamar, ABC's Good Morning America will broadcast live outside in Times Square.
Yeah.
Which might, now that I think about it, result in Joan London's return. Considering her reputation, she'd probably feel a lot more comfortable on a street corner in Times Square than in a bloody studio, be Jesus. Filthy hussy.
I don't think that's necessary.
And there's Jeopardy this week from Washington, D.C., Imus Lamar. Special Ed Jeopardy.
Mm-hmm.
Earlier in the week, we saw Tim meet the Dunce Russell.
So you guys remember what you remember your part here. When the general says, "Why are we here?" You all scream to collect that debt.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
Oh, man, this is like a Wayne Newton show in Vegas, isn't it? Yeah.
It's
Jesus, man, it's like Tony Orlando and Branson trying to get you to sing along with Hiya Yellow Ribbon. You know, if you can remember to do it, fine. If you can't, we don't care.
No, we don't.
All right, here now, I'm Mr. Washington, Senior Military Affairs Advisor, the late General George S. Patton, Jr.
At ease, as you were. All right. Good morning, maggots. I said good morning, maggots. Better. First of all, thank you for volunteering to participate in Operation Desert Deadbeat. As you know, it is hazardous, sensitive. Some of you will not be coming back. Now then, looking out at you, I realize that none of you has come here straight from a desk at the Brookings Institute. Therefore, I will speak slowly and use little words as I take a moment to ingratiate myself with you locals by making a few references with which you'll be familiar. Jeff Foxworthy. Tammy Faye. The dog is licking the baby again. Repo. Rent to buy. Present photo ID when paying with food stamps. And beer. It's not just for breakfast anymore. Are you comfortable now?
Yeah.
Very well. Let me background the battlefield for you people. There comes a time in the lives of men when injustice can no longer be ignored. We saw it in my beautiful World War II, Korea, Vietnam. We see it today in Bosnia, Iraq, places where the promise of a square deal has been broken, places where people have been stiffed by the greed, avarice, and merciless contempt concentrated in a few dictatorial sons of bitches who get a hard-on by planting a jackboot in the necks of the downtrodden.
No.
And we find it this morning, people, right here in the capital city of the Empire State of the South, Atlanta, Georgia, where a corporate despot has decided to usurp money pledged to children who have cancer.
No.
Who is this invidious individual? Ted Turner, cable boy, founder of the Clinton News Network, and what shall forevermore be known as the Ill Will Games, whose ticket sales, it was agreed, would in part be used to help fund our facility for training children in techniques of unconventional warfare, codenamed the Imus Ranch for Kids with Cancer. We are here, people, to collect that debt. Why are we here?
To collect that debt!
I can't hear you! Why are we here? Sound off like a head of hair!
To collect that debt!
To collect that debt, what?
To collect that debt, sir!
That's more like it. All right, now, the assault plan is straightforward. In a matter of minutes, we will double time battalion strength directly to our objective, CNN Central, where we will take out CNN Command and Control by capturing Lou Waters and Natalie Allen, if for no other reason than to keep Lou from fiddling with Natalie's knees under the anchor desk. We have had enough of that behavior in Washington, D.C. No smart weapons will be required. It is, after all, CNN, whose day-to-day operations are run by Rick Kaplan, the dumbest bastard ever conceived. In fact, when we get there, I will get down on my hands and knees behind him, and you push the idiot over backwards. Hurry now. When you leave the ready room, you'll find Bradley fighting vehicles and Hummers available to you just outside.
What?
Well, I don't mean Hummers in the intern sense of the word. I mean Humvees, troop transports. Ready, Private?
Sir.
He ain't exactly in the red.
He ain't exactly in the red.
So we're here to drop a rock on Ted.
We're here to drop a rock on Ted.
Let's move out, maggots. That is all.
All right. 29 after the hour. We are on the zone, 7:90 a.m. in Atlanta, Georgia.
I see a little silhouette of a man.
Scaramouche, Scaramouche, will you do the fandango?
Thunderbolt and lightning, very, very frightening me.
Galileo,
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 Galileo, Galileo,
Galileo. I'm just a poor boy and nobody loves me.
He's just a poor boy from a poor family, sparing his life from this monstrosity.
I'm a sin in the morning.
In your shorts, 2020 sports.
Yankees win! Ah! Yankees win!
Another triumph for the New York Yankees. Good morning, Mike Greenwood Sports, saying hi to the I-Man fans in Atlanta, the greatest city in the world! New York Yankees, of course, won the World Series. Only reason the Yankees won the World Series is that they didn't have to play those amazing Atlanta Braves. But even after the season is long over, the Yankees are still winning awards, as yesterday Joe Torre named American League Manager of the Year. But Torre did not seem happy with the honor. At the press conference to accept the award, he was very curt with reporters and had some disparaging words about owner George Steinbrenner.
He's tough to work for.
Although that remark basically harmless, Torre raised some eyebrows when he was asked if he hates Steinbrenner.
I really do.
You know, Steinbrenner is yet to respond to the harsh words, but according to my sources, Torre will be fired by the end of the weekend because of those remarks. NFL weekend coming up. The game, battle for first in the NFC West, the 7-2 Atlanta Falcons. They'll be hosting the 7-2 San Francisco 49ers. Falcons, the surprise team in the league this season. Coach Dan Reeves is enjoying his time with his team.
It was a great thrill to be around young men.
Reeves says he's always enjoyed being around young men. Young, athletic, sweaty men. Young, athletic, sweaty men with bulging muscles. Young, athletic, sweaty men with bulging muscles standing half-naked in a locker room.
That'll be fine.
49ers, meanwhile, have dominated the Falcons recently, but they're not overconfident. San Francisco quarterback Steve Young says he's impressed with the Falcons' personnel.
A lot of big, strong players.
Young says he has admiration for big, strong players. For young, sweaty, big, strong players. Young, sweaty, big, strong players. Okay. Moving on to other sports, steroids has reared its ugly head in pro sports again, resulting in the dismissal of a champion athlete in Japan. His name is Junsuke Inoue, dropped by the Japanese national team for testing positive for a banned steroid use. What was his sport? Billiards. A first now, a steroid-taking pool player, Junsuke Inoue, done in Japan.
What would the make the balls are much stronger.
How would that help you playing pool, I wonder? I don't quite understand.
It don't help you play pool, but it help you later on with the cheeks.
Plus, he's playing pocket pool. By the way, it was nice to see Jane Fonda stop by the stage a little bit earlier today.
No, that...
Looks a little older on TV, though, don't you think?
You know, here's the nightmare. The old bag from the record company, it turns out... You know, you can't make this stuff up. It turns out that she owns the bus that we want to use to go over to see it. I mean, I don't understand this. So we need now to get a... Where's Salsa? Salsa, come here. Well, now, go ahead, Mike.
Well, that's sports. I'm Mike Breen.
Great. Give Mike a nice hand.
All right.
11 minutes till the hour here.
It's a nightmare.
Well, we thought that, let me just take this opportunity now to apologize to the lady from the record company.
The lovely lady
from the record company, who I'm sure has every intention of paying me and Charles all that money they owe us. But anyway, the bus is being provided by who? The Four Seasons Hotel?
The Four Seasons Hotel made the arrangements, and this is the woman they called.
Unbelievable.
Of all the people, 270 million people in the country.
I'll give them a bus.
Well, I'm she's a nice lady, and I was just kind of kidding around. She was hysterical about it, but I mean, the truth is, they never paid me. So it's not a big deal. I don't know, you know, obviously I don't need the money, but I mean, it is sort of the principle.
Sure.
But, so I think I intimated on the air that she was a crook, but I don't think I actually meant that.
I think it was just a figure of speech and reflected your anger of the moment.
I was talking metaphorically about... Yeah. Well, anyway, here's Salsa now from the zone here, and... In Atlanta.
Yeah.
Well, what is the status of the bus?
The status of the bus didn't happen. The lady who owns the bus would not let Bernard and his band of merry pranksters onto the bus.
Oh, yeah.
So the bus didn't happen. However, being that we are in Atlanta, Georgia, five nice young gentlemen with pickup trucks came by. Everybody piled in the pickup trucks with Bo and his bats are in the pickup trucks. They are headed down to CNN Center as we speak.
Hey, all right.
This is even better.
So the fat crook from the bus can take the bus and shove it up her fat butt.
That's right. Put it in her bus barn butt.
Yeah. Absolutely. All right. It's we'll await for their arrival in the pickups, and how appropriate. You're absolutely right. Here in Atlanta. So the pickups are on their way to CNN headquarters, and we'll talk to Bernie coming up. It is now coming up on 8 minutes till the hour.
It was always so easy to find an unhappy woman.
If you're a telecommunication...
Come over there.
Would have been a good idea. Well, Bernard and about 50 or 60 members of the audience here are over now in front of CNN headquarters with Bo Deedle, Joey Pots and Pans, Jimmy the Wags, a couple of Georgia State Troopers. I guess they're off duty. I would hope. Maybe retiring from their position as Georgia State Troopers after this morning. Fiasco. And the reason we went to CNN is because we didn't know where else to go. The Goodwill Games, not to bore you to death with this, but last summer came to me and said, we'll give you a dollar for every ticket we sell to the Imus Ranch, which is this cattle ranch my brother and my wife and I are building out in New Mexico. And we're going to take kids who have cancer and other kids out there and teach them how to be little cowboys and cowgirls. And so I thought that was very nice of them to offer to contribute the money. And then when it came time to give me the money, they started complaining that I hadn't promoted their stupid Goodwill games enough, which was absurd. Of course they had. We even had Ted Turner on the air, and I would point out, as I said before, you know, he's a nice guy. He's done a lot of good things, but he was a horrible guest. And I don't know whether he hadn't taken his medication or he'd taken, as Charles pointed out, maybe he took too much. You know, being a recovering drug addict, I know how sometimes you can just take too much. And you're not out, you know?
Yeah.
And then they tried to tell me, yesterday, one of the Turner, it's probably not Ted's fault, it's probably Turner executive's fault, tried to tell me that they had some sort of contract with me. Well, I mean, they're lying. It's preposterous. I want my money. So we didn't know where to go, so we're over in front of CNN headquarters. Let's go to Bernard and see what's going on over there now. Good morning, Bernard.
First home run.
Hey, boss, how you doing, Chief? We're here outside Centennial Park, outside CNN headquarters. Of course, Centennial Park was the site where the bomb went off during the Olympics. And there's another bomb about to go off, and that's us here, I mean. We're about to hit CNN like Hurricane Mitch hit the Honduras. We're about to Rodney King the network of Bernard Shaw. We want the money. We want the money.
We want the money.
I don't know. But I've been told.
I don't know, but I've been told.
Ted Turner's got some bags of gold.
Ted Turner's got some bags of gold.
He owes some kids with cancer money.
He owes some kids with cancer money.
And the odd man doesn't think it's funny.
The odd man doesn't think it's funny.
Come on, man. First he slanders V advance.
First he slanders V advance.
Now he doesn't pay his debts.
Now he doesn't pay his debts.
Gets his wife some fancy dresses.
Gets his wife some fancy dresses.
Not to mention phony brushes.
Not to mention phony
brushes.
Pay up.
Pay up.
Pay up.
Pay up. Won't you be for? We roar! Yay!
Bernard McGurk live at Centennial Park.
Ted's got to pay the dough. Hey, hey.
Now, if you're somebody from the Goodwill Games, wouldn't you have wanted to avoid this? Why not just write the check and we can end this madness? Jimmy the Wags, Joey Potts and Pans flew down from New York, and also a couple of our friends, Georgia State Troopers, have agreed to pitch in and help knock some heads over there. We're just waiting for Lou Walters. Lou Walters and Natalie Allen to show up so we can take them captive. And let's go back to Bernard now and see what's going on, Bernard.
Chief, we're here outside CNN headquarters. Bo screaming and charging up the crowd. We're looking for Flip Spiceland, maybe break his knees, or maybe to get Candy Crowley's lunch money or something to help these kids with cancer. Bo, what do you think?
Well, all I can say is Ted Turner better pay up because we come here. I got Mark McGuire's 71st home run bat here.
Oh, yeah, you got a bargain.
Oh, there's only 70?
And we have other outraged citizens. We have signs up. We have this gentleman here. Sir, what's your problem?
Well, Ted Turner's donated or promised to donate $500 million to UN kids, and he's so cheap he won't even help American kids that got cancer.
Yeah!
Well,
hey, sir.
You know, I mean...
What's the difference between Ted Turner and Clinton?
No.
What's that?
Let's just not go there.
No, you mean Jane Fonda and Bill Clinton. The difference, Bo, is at least Jane Fonda went to Vietnam.
All right, but I'm McGurk, live off front of CNN headquarters. It's a quarter after the hour here on I'm Mr. Money Program. We'll be back to Bernard and all the troops out in front of CNN headquarters. Well, I don't want to cop out here, but I don't want to malign Ted personally because you know you get this sneaking suspicion that maybe he doesn't know what's going on, but it's his job to know what's going on, and the buck stops with him, and so it's just going to get uglier throughout the morning. And you know the thing I keep thinking, last summer, you know, the Goodwill Games are over. They ended like in August. I mean, as I pointed out earlier this morning, I'm the idiot who went down to Washington and made fun of the president with him sitting 3 feet from me, sweating all over the first lady.
Right.
I mean, what did they think I was... any idiot who would do that is certainly not going to let something like this slide, are they?
You peed in a phone booth. Come
Absolutely.
On.
Absolutely.
Please.
I mean, you know, I used to do... I mean, I'm not proud of this, but I used to do cocaine on the radio. I mean, I'll do anything.
Horrible.
Anyway, the business report is sponsored by the New York... Georgia, our guy Zell Miller is coming up.
On July the 2nd, 1953, I was serving time for armed robbery. At 4 o'clock in the morning, I was sleeping in my cell. I heard a whistle blow, then I heard somebody yell.
I'm a sin in the morning.
Their mission is to deliver...
Bernard McGurk is over in front of CNN headquarters. We're trying to find out if Lou Waters or Natalie Allen or Flip Spiflin or somebody has that Goodwill money. Let's go back to Bernard now. Bernard?
Hey, hey, hey. Ho, ho. Ben Turner's got to pay the dough.
Hey, hey. Ben Turner's got to pay the dough. Hey, hey.
Okay, let's go.
Hey, you clumsy
chump. Bernard, we're on the air here to try to please settle Bo down. Those people just...
We're getting evicted situation. Hi, man.
What's the problem?
The state police, apparently on the turn of payroll, are making us abandon the premises.
Oh, they are?
So we're going to go run and storm the CNN headquarters right now. Like it was Porkchop Hill, I mean.
What? We wanted to kind of avoid any sort of... We wanted to avoid an incident where you got arrested, Bernard.
Hey, can the governor intercede, I mean?
We don't want to get the governor involved in this. The governor would like to stay out of this, if you don't mind.
We go to the can. Can the governor pardon us?
Can
the governor get us out of jail tonight?
Well, the governor has 7 weeks to go, and one of the things he doesn't want to do is get involved with all of you. We'll go back to Bernard in just a few minutes. Bernard and Joey Potts and Pans, Bo Deedle, a couple of Georgia State troopers who are apparently off duty this morning, and about half the audience over in front of CNN headquarters and being forcibly moved now by the police, who apparently... or on the Turner payroll, although we wouldn't want to make those.
No.
We wouldn't want to make serious allegations.
Absolutely.
Well, here in the midst, 24 Giuliani.
I'd like to hear some funky Dixieland. Pretty mama, come and take me by the hand.
I want to hang tight, take me by the hand. Pretty mama, come and dance with your daddy all night long.
I'd like to hear some funky Dixieland. Pretty mama, come and take me by the hand.
I miss in the morning.
All right, let me talk to you in Atlanta, Georgia, at the Fox Theater Complex. Well, apparently Bernard now and everybody, they've been evicted over there from by the police, who clearly are on the CNN's payroll.
Yeah.
And so they're on their way back over here. I'm looking at the monitor on MSNBC. It looks like Bernard is now in handcuffs. Hey. Well, here he is.
There we go.
Leading the troops. So we'll get a full report from Bernard. Bernard walking in with... we are in Atlanta on the zone, 790. I know some of you obviously didn't agree with Governor Miller and his position on the president, but Charles and I were talking about that. I have great admiration. What happened over there, Bernard?
We were evicted by the state police.
That was not the state police. That was Jewel, that kid Jewel. He got a job now. He heads up the parks department over there. He's on the take. I'm not kidding you. He's over there. He came out there. He looked like, what did he look like? A little like Porky Piggy. And he came out and he says, "You're on state land." I said, "Well, we're in your state." And he goes, "Bo, you're in a state of shock." And then he brought some other guys over there with some flak jackets on and some automatic weapons. And we decided then we should levitate before it got a little vibrated.
All we needed was a box of Krispy Kremes, I think, and we could have stayed. From the looks of those guys. But we came back empty-handed, I remember. We're willing to go back and take another expeditionary force in a little while when the truck gets set up, the satellite truck, and try to collect this money for kids with cancer.
Yeah!
Well, we understand there may be a contingent of somebody representing the Turner Empire who may be coming over here, so maybe you should stay here, because it could develop into an ugly situation here.
We're ready,
okay.
Baby.
Well, Bo, we just don't want to smack anybody with a bat at this point.
Come on, bitches, let's go.
I don't think that, come on, bitches, let's go is where we want to go. At this point.
Well, we did find out some intelligence in the hotel. There's a hotel attached to the Turner Network Broadcast Center. We heard that Hillary Clinton was there.
No,
Hillary Clinton was there.
Hey, shut his mic off, please. At 17 till the hour here at the Hollywood Program.
Imus in the morning. 2020 sports.
Showdown at the Georgia Dome. Good morning, Mike Greenwood Sports. The red-hot Atlanta Falcons looking for sole possession of first place in the NFC West Sunday. They will host the San Francisco 49ers. Both teams are 7-2.
Falcons running back Jamal Anderson was asked how he thinks he'll play against a tough Niner defense.
I want to do good. I ain't going to do bad. I ain't going to do that bad. You know, I'm not saying I'm going to do good, but I ain't going to do that bad.
Anderson has been terrific this year and a fine spokesman for the NFL and the Falcons.
Oh, that's just great, Mike.
Also this weekend, the struggling Brett Favre and the Green Bay Packers visit the New York Giants. And the latest controversy with the Pack concerns head coach Mike Holmgren, who was asked how he motivates the players.
I can bring out whips and chains and stuff at practice and rant and rave.
Holmgren said he got into sadomasochism in college and feels it has helped him now in his NFL career. From baseball, American League Manager of the Year, Joe Torre of the Yankees. No surprise there, as Torre's team won 114 regular season games and then the World Series. Torre's second Manager of the Year award. He was asked who has influenced his life the most.
Probably the man that made the most impact on me was Reggie
Skelton.
An unusual choice for Torre, but Joe said he always wanted to be in vaudeville, but settled for a baseball career instead.
You know, you really are just
an idiot.
A disgraceful human being.
In the NBA, no new talk scheduled, but the continuing of criticism of the players, including Union President Patrick Ewing. Ewing was asked if he's being heavily influenced by his agent David Falk and the chief negotiator Billy Hunter.
If there's something I need to ask him, I'm definitely going to ask him. That's what I pay him for. But, you know, if I need other advice, that's what I pay Billy for also. Billy is our legal counsel. So, you know, David's my agent and my lawyer, and Billy's, you know, the lawyer for the union. So, you know, whatever advice I need, I'm going to go and I'm going to seek it.
Makes you confident the lockout will end soon, doesn't it?
Well,
he could easily be an editor for George Magazine.
Now that's sports. I'm Mike Breen.
That's a quarter till the hour, and we're on the zone here in Atlanta. So, but did you run? Did we see any? Because the idea was we were going to take a collection from CNN employees, many of them who are embarrassed by the behavior of the Turner Empire. Did we run into any CNN employees?
No, unfortunately, at the last minute, they threw the MSNBC cameras off the premises.
Oh, they did.
Forced us across the street into Centennial Park, where we were then thrown off by the state police and ended up having no place to go and therefore collected no money so far. But we're going to go back.
I don't know. Is that a good idea to go back, Bo? We can turn both mic on until he starts to misbehave again.
I think there could be a little derogatory action over there. Bernie doesn't understand the arrest laws down here in the great state of Georgia. Bernie, they put you on a farm down here, chain gang. You know what I'm saying?
Now,
you're a northerner, Bernie. You're from New York.
You would
you know
be somebody's girlfriend by 6 o'clock.
You'd be somebody's bitch. Wouldn't be the first time.
It wouldn't?
No, not at all.
All right, well, we'll talk more about this coming up. It's 14 till the hour, and we're here in Atlanta on the zone, 7:90 a.m. on the AM dial.
Don't send me anything, period. But don't send me any gifts for Wyatt. Don't send it. So somebody makes some pottery here.
Yeah.
It's kind of actually sort of neat-looking stuff. Some guy from another guy's name or some nitwit.
Idiot.
Well, it's cute, but it's...
But it's wrong.
It's wrong. And then on the back, they have written his name. It's spelled Frederick wrong. You know, there's a cute little bowl and cup and...
Well,
I mean, not even what he wants, but...
It's outrageous.
Well, wait a minute. You can't just put it in the damn cup. Oh,
well, don't send the stuff. Just stop sending it.
If your radio sounds funny in the morning, you're listening to Imus in the morning.
I feel badly now about breaking a guy's pottery.
No, you don't.
I wonder if I should call a guy and see if he's that upset.
All right,
you should do something.
You should call and apologize.
Some kind of amends. You can apologize for nothing. He should apologize.
You don't get it.
You just don't get it, man.
I don't get what?
Yeah, well, you need to be put to sleep today. Forget Atlanta. just put him out.
Imus in the morning. Sports Radio 66.
Going to advise because the disgraceful dirtbags at CNN don't have a sense of humor. They threw us off of the premises over there, right?
That's correct.
And then the crooked police authorities here in Georgia are all clearly on CNN's payroll.
Yeah, on the pad.
Yeah, evicted Bernie and all the folks from even across the street, right?
Right. We had no place to go.
So why did they say you couldn't stay across the street? What was their problem with that?
Well, that was CNN property on that side.
Oh.
And then it would have taken the truck another half hour to get just across the street. So effectively, they cut us off.
What happened to your voice, screaming?
I was leading a chant with the outraged citizens of Georgia.
Yeah.
And I sort of lost my voice. Yeah.
Well, you did a good job, and at some point, somebody may show up here from... Maybe one of his wrestlers
kind of get the message here.
Yeah, we need somebody like Kofi Annan to meet it. Kofi no cream Annan.
I'm telling you right now, brother, as God is my witness, so long as I'm drawing breath, no harm comes to Ted Turner, brother. Jane Fonda, that's another story altogether. You go for it. No love lost there. Years ago, I'm a Navy SEAL. I'm chin deep in a rice paddy in Da Nang. Charlie's lobbing mortars in over my head. Things are burning around me, and this pinko prostitute is out there
smoking
opium with Ho Chi Minh, brother. You won't ever catch me and her in the same room together, brother. I'm on a hair trigger. That rib cage that passes for a woman so much it looks at me cross-eyed, I snap her like a carrot stick, brother. You open up a can of whoop-ass when you decide to mess with me, brother. You think you're the I-Man? I'm ire and indignation personified, brother. I'm a raging sea, a boiling cauldron of molten anger. Dip your tootsies in the fury that is me, brother. You play with me, you're playing with fire. And from where I'm sitting, you already look like a burn victim, so back down, brother. You know, rude Rick Kaplan tried to mess with me when he first came to CNN, and you know what happened to him?
No.
Next time you see him, he'll be lying in a pine box in front of a chroma key of Arlington Cemetery, brother. I'm the one who put him there.
Just turn over the money, meathead.
I'm Hurricane Mitch and you're Latin America, brother. I'll blow you over like a Honduran lean-to.
That will be fun.
And I'll snap the wrinkles out of your neck like a cotton bedsheet. I'll give you a prostate massage with a clam knife, brother.
4 minutes till the hour.
I'm a single morning.
If we don't have your book, nobody does.
I'm a...
All right, let me talk to you now about, well, I have no idea. Oh, okay, A&E. Well, every night on the A&E Network, biography brings you something completely unexpected. The real lives of the people you thought you knew, their private dreams and struggles, their intrigues and their inspirations. From politicians to celebrities, from world leaders to sports legends, biography provides fascinating insight into their real lives, the one and only biography. Can only be found on A&E Biography, the people you thought you knew. Now 7 nights a week on A&E Network. Tonight on Biography, Camilla Parker Bowles. Wasn't she on last night, or did I read this earlier?
You read this earlier, I
okay.
Did.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I'm starting to lose it here.
Well, that's okay.
Insisting I'm referring to myself in the third person, which is beyond my ability to even explain.
Very attractive.
For over 25 years, Miss Bowles' relationship with Prince Charles has been one much like the president's been conducting with various women around the country. 8 p.m. Eastern on A&E, Escape the Ordinary. All right. Are you satisfied with your internet service provider? Well, you may not be. And if you aren't, are you considering logging on the internet for the first time? Well, it can be confusing, and we had to walk Charles through this.
Sure.
Teach him how to turn his computer on.
Still can't do it.
Now we have Mindspring Internet Services, which is a direct connection to the internet with 24-hour day, 7-day-a-week free customer support. Now, I know I don't seem that enthusiastic about this particular sponsor, but believe me, I am, and I think it's a fine service, and it's something that you probably ought to get involved in if you'd like to. You know, they make it very simple for you. They have fast, reliable 56K connections, which means that... This means it's very fast. Just get John like that.
Yep.
They have award-winning service. Mindspring wants to be your internet provider. So if you'll call them at 1-888-M-SPRING, they'll work it out for you. Now, I desperately wish I had more time to tell you about this, but gosh, we're out of time. But just take my word for it. You give them a call, 1-888-M-SPRING. Mindspring for fast, reliable, direct access to the internet guaranteed. So you all check that out.
communications fan. Highway Patrol taking a look at Queens. The northbound Cross Island Parkway is down to a crawl because of a stall approaching Hillside Boulevard.
This is the morning program, and we're live in Atlanta on the zone. 790 on the dial. Jeep now. All right, it's the quarter till the hour. What time are the wrestlers going to come in and I'm supposed to pretend to be surprised? What time will that happen? Why don't we have them come in now and then I'll pretend to be surprised.
Okay.
And you guys all cheer and then we'll talk to Hulk Hogan or whatever he calls himself now.
Yeah. Talk real slow.
We'll tell you, you small person.
And you'll feign shock.
Well, we don't. All right, let's do some spots. We'll come back with them.
Sure.
Quarter till they are.
Well, I guess it would be nice if I could touch your body. I know not everybody has got a body like you. I miss in the morning.
Worldwide headlines are screwed.
Lori McNichol for the Nextel Communications Fan Highway Patrol.
I miss in the morning. 2020 sports.
In Atlanta, Georgia, on the zone, they're waiting to be surprised by... Well, here he is now! Ooh. Ooh. Walking in here,
like a
on the I Miss in the Morning program, is Hollywood Hulk Hogan.
Toilet paper in his shoe.
From the... from now the end... We're going to put him over here, right? Okay. All right, y'all give a nice hand to Hulk Hogan. Is it Hulk or is it now Hollywood, Hogan? Maybe I should speak slower.
Just speak with more confidence, brother.
So is it Hollywood? Is it Hollywood Hogan now or Hulk Hogan?
Because it's Mr. President to you.
You left that dirtbag Vince McMahon, right?
Well, no comment on dirtbags today.
Anyway, why are you here?
Well, I'm here because I was really, really upset when I saw somebody else stepping on my turf and trying to rough Ted Turner up, because everybody knows that the only man that roughs Ted Turner up is Hollywood Hogan.
Yeah.
And I heard Imus's real weak rap that Ted Turner doesn't pay his bills and Ted Turner doesn't step up to the plate when he makes a commitment.
Yeah.
Well, even though Ted and I don't see eye to eye, Ted Turner always pays up. He always steps up to the plate. So what I did, because Ted made the promise that for every ticket sold, he was going to donate $1 to Kids Cancer to your fund, brother.
Yeah.
I went ahead and waited until the Eye Man was in Atlanta. We wanted to see him in person. We wanted to look in his eyes.
This is very weak, by the way.
No, it's real.
This is so lame. It's making
You're going to think real weak when you see this check. But anyway, my friend, I went ahead and got the check from Ted Turner. I ruffled his feathers, and I'm here to present it to you, man, because you did a great job in helping the kids out, and this check is for you and for your fund right
Thank
here.
You. Yeah.
Wait a minute, muscle. So if you still think that's who, hey, if Imus Pimus Smimus still thinks that's really weak, we can step right here in the center and I'll show you what weak is.
Get him, boss.
Here's the point I was making, and the point I was making is that why did I have to bitch about it for 6 months and then come down to Atlanta and get in Ted Turner's face before he coughed up the money? So he should have given me the money last summer. It was very nice of you to come over with it.
I mean, that was very weak of Fat Ted and that hideous wife of his not to come up with the money when they were supposed to come up with it.
Wow, no comment on Ted or his wife.
I mean, I had to make a big issue out of this whole thing and bitch about it. And, of course, that's why you're here this morning. If it weren't for you, we wouldn't have got the money.
Amen.
You're the hero.
Yeah, so you're the hero.
You're the good guy.
Well, I'm glad you finally figured that out. Thank you.
Hollywood Hogan is here also with Eric Bischoff, who is Hogan's, well, what is his campaign manager? You know, you're running, you're jumping on this Jesse the Body Ventura bandwagon, or what's that all about?
No, I'm just listening to the people, man. The people are tired of these plastic politicians. The people are tired of a lot of people blasting the United States of America for having these special interest groups and different agendas. And so, just like in Minnesota, when the people voiced their opinion, they wanted a real man to make real decisions. Hollywood Hogan at first started listening to the people, you know, after this Ventura thing started to snowball.
Yeah.
And the people of America, brother, they want somebody with no hidden agendas. They want somebody, when a bill or a decision comes across the big desk in the Oval Office, they don't want anybody playing with cigars or anything like that. They want somebody to make a decision on what's good for America and what's good for the people of the United States. I've been around the block a few times. All the stuff President Clinton is going through, I've already experienced, my friend. So the bottom line is, I've gone through that midlife crisis already. I'm ready to be the world's heavyweight champion again. And I think that I'm the man that could set this country straight and make the right decision, right or wrong, yes or no. I'm the man to do it.
Let me ask you about a couple of issues.
Hollywood.
Yeah, Hollywood.
Yeah.
What should we do? Let's talk about a couple of issues. Iraq. What should we do with them?
You know, Iraq, I think we should have already been in and out of there. This thing is just going on and on and on. If we'd have nailed the sucker the first time, we should have our men out of there right now. There's no reason to spend the people's money, waste the jet fuel, put people's lives in jeopardy. You know, we should be at home protecting America. We shouldn't be going across the country bombing people two or three times. Get it right the first time. Just like when I set my sights on somebody in the ring, I take them down the first time and I win the match. There's no reason to have to spend more money because you didn't get it done the first time. That's what should have happened.
Okay, now, another issue. A lot of the Republicans are demonizing the homosexuals. And, of course, we heard you were gay. How do you feel about that?
Hollywood, I told you when we came here you weren't allowed to kick the hell out of them, but I'm beginning to wonder.
Well, you know, brother, from the smell and the fragrance of that stinky perfume you have on, you're definitely not my type.
Anyway, y'all give a nice hand to Hollywood Hogan.
Yeah.
Hey,
whoa,
John, hold on, you know something? We really, really do appreciate what you're doing for kids, because kids has always been my forte. I've got a couple healthy children myself, and every time I look at them, I realize how fortunate I am to have healthy kids. I deal a lot with the Special Olympics, with the Make-A-Wish, with the Dalmatian Foundation, and I really appreciate, all joking aside, what this man does for all the kids out there.
And that's what I'm saying.
The bottom line is, he's got a little son at home, Wyatt, and Wyatt's already screaming Hollywood for president. So listen to the kids, man.
Yeah.
Hollywood Hogan here at the Ivy Center program. Thank you guys very much.
Thank you.
Get past the people. Get past the hitmen.
I'm a in the morning.
Tonight on Legacy.
He's on his own. We want squished towel heads by noon. That's what we want. You know what I'm saying?
Bowls
and
And the devil even speak a... I mean, he's telling him okay, didn't he?
Well, he's running for office now, so he's got to clean up that.
Well, who are the other guys with him?
Well, Eric Bischoff, obviously, is his campaign manager. And then Scott Steiner, one of the Steiner brothers. I don't know who the dude was with the big top hat, but he scared me. What? Yeah, right.
Who?
I have no idea.
Some silly bitch.
Okay, but I mean, but they look like they'd... I mean, that's a steroid deal, isn't all those? I mean, those kinds of muscles.
That's from hard work.
It is, okay. Anyway, apparently Ted Turner and all of them, you know, I realize it got ugly, got all the way up to big... in the corporate offices yesterday in New York and Atlanta, and the phone lines are burning up. But the net is they presented me with a check here for the Imus Ranch for $157,000, and we greatly appreciate that. And but, I mean, I don't want to be a phony about it. I mean, if I hadn't bitched about it and caused a scene, and what would have happened?
Well, you wouldn't be holding the check.
I wouldn't be holding the check.
No,
I mean, it's nice of them to give the check, but what choice did they have?
None.
Because I wasn't going to shut up about it.
Sure.
Anyway, but it is nice of them, and we'll see if it clears. It's 20 minutes. Well, I'm not going to be a phony about it.
Of course not.
It's 20 minutes after the hour, and here now, one of our favorite people who appears every 2 or 3 weeks with us, he's not that enthusiastic about appearing on a program, but we like having him. Please welcome Hall of Fame football player Terry Bradshaw. Good morning.
Hey, good morning. Take some of that $157,000. Go get your face fixed.
You know, I just wish you were here so I could whoop up on your ass. That's what I wish. So anyway, how are you?
Oh, man, I'm just up. I'm just excited that I finally made the show on time.
Now, you're a half an hour late, Terry.
Am I half an hour late?
Yeah, for dummies, which we think Terry should have written. But anyway, Terry Bradshaw here in the program. It's 29 after the hour. We're live.
Just because I asked a friend about
Mike Brain.
Imus in the Morning 2024 rolls on.
An NFL matchup to die for. Good morning, Mike Brain with sports. This Sunday, the Atlanta Falcons continue their march towards the Super Bowl as they host the San Francisco 49ers. What's at stake? First place in the NFC West. Both teams are 7-2. Falcons have had great play this season from quarterback Chris Chandler, who says when he takes the snap from center, he thinks of the football in an intimate way.
There's a moment that you think, well, I could go down on this.
No. It obviously works for Chandler, who's one of the leading quarterbacks in the league this season. Also, Saints and Rams this weekend in a game no one cares about, except that New Orleans will start that team leader, community-minded quarterback, Kerry Collins. Coach Mike Ditka discussed the situation.
I think when we ride Kerry in here, we said what we were going to do. I mean, not to do that. I mean, it would be a little bit foolish. I mean, it would mean that we were crazy. I know a lot of people think I'm crazy, but I don't know if I'm that crazy.
Does he want us to answer that?
At what point does his head explode?
Great news for tennis fans. As Steffi Graf has qualified for next week's season-ending Chase Championships at Madison Square Garden. Graf beat Elena Lukotseva to clinch her berth in a match that was filled with plenty of trash talking. Lukotseva had some harsh words for Graf afterwards.
Честно говоря, я рисковала, делая эти блоки на лоб, перед тем, как мне свистнули фол технически на ней же. Я очень рисковала, но я шла на этот риск, потому что надо было. Но в такой момент был матч, выигрывали только.
Lukotseva saying Graf is a bitch who should get a nose job. And that Steffi is the last player on the tour she would have a lesbian relationship with. Which says a lot. In baseball, American League Manager of the Year Joe Torre of the New York Yankees, who spoke of his relationship with the owner, George Steinbrenner.
As far as I'm concerned, what he does for me is much more important than what he may do to me.
Mm-hmm. Torre providing no details, but said spanking has been performed. And this is Mike Breen saying, so long, everybody!
Mike Breen live in New York. It is 20 minutes till the hour. You know, one of the things, well, I'll tell you in just a second here.
All right, we're rolling. Take one. What's the name of this?
Little Village. A little village, mother. Little village.
Motherfucking there by the village, you son of a bitch. Nothing the song has got anything to do with a village.
Well, a small town.
You know what a village is?
Well, all right, damn it. You don't name them titles. You name it after you got it. I'm not getting you with it, son of a bitch. You name what you want it. You name it your mammy if you want it.
Take one. Roll it.
Mm-mm. It's too fast, baby.
Take two. Slow it up.
I miss in the morning.
Life on the...
Do that. Yeah, this is a different airline. Then Joey had to get up and go to the men's room. She says, well, there's this thing that you use. It was one of these bottles there you're supposed to pass around. Don, Tram Air.
Why didn't you come down with us on the iJet?
Well, I had a little dinnertation at Rayo's last night.
Oh, I see. Okay.
I was there. I had my hootenanny table. And I knew you were going to need some help there because the Hulkster had some badass-looking guys there, Don.
Well, I'm very pleased to report that Hollywood Hogan did show up with a check for $157,000.
Yeah.
And we didn't have to jump ugly with him, you know?
Oh, you're not going to get jump ugly with me, brother. By the time I'm done with you, you'll be taking a lot of things for granted, brother. Like walking, eating, and breathing. You're not going to be able to do any of those things anymore, brother. I'm going to give you a whole Hollywood Hogan anal probe. And I'm going to do it with your own arm, brother. I'm going to pull it off you like a wing of a fly. It's going to be really hard for you to walk around with another arm stuck between your legs, brother. I got nothing to lose, brother. I spent every nickel I ever made. My movie career is stillborn. Got no retirement plan. So 6 nights a week, I got to still get into a sweat pretending I'm slapping the crap out of a bunch of bikers in white face and spandex, brother. I'm 57 years old. I'm still shaving my chest, brother. You know what I'm saying? Self-esteem ain't an issue no more, brother. I've lost the will to live. See, you and me doing the dance, that's one step closer to me ending this living hell I call a life, brother.
Is that pretty much it, Hulk? Run out of juice, Hulk?
I still got plenty of juice to kick your ass, brother.
It's 11 minutes till the hour here on the Ivan's of the Morning program. Well, it's been a fairly... The only ugly incident was the fat babe from the record company.
Right.
Yeah. Down here trying to cash in on our... These are. I don't know if she was with the old record company. It's the same record company. Used to be Bang Records back in the 70s.
That's about as close as
I would rather to get one. I'd rather take this records. Pen and put it in my nose and bang that one.
Oh,
wow.
That's fine. But, you know, in the great tradition of Morris Levy and some of the other real dirtbags of the record industry, this woman apparently is down there trying to sell this album that they never paid me for in the first place, and she wonders why I'm not enthusiastic about it. And so that has been the only ugly incident here this morning.
Yeah.
And apparently she had a bus, and we were going to use that to go over to CNN, but she wouldn't let us use the bus.
We had pickup trucks.
So we wound up getting in, you know... But I would encourage you, one, the album was when I used to do stand-up 20 years ago, and I was very drunk when I recorded the album.
Yes, I know.
Which if you listen, you can tell.
Yeah.
So, and if you'd like a copy of it, why waste money and give money to this crook from the record company when, in fact, we're never going to get it, so if you'll just write me a note.
Sure.
God knows why you'd even want this, but if you do, why... I'll be happy to send you a little cassette of it free of charge.
Leave the album to
no problem. Yeah.
Get that.
Screw the skank.
Yes. Yeah.
Screw the what?
Screw the skank. That's very nice, Bernie.
Very good, Bernie.
Anyway, the radio station here, Steak and Salsa and all of them, and everybody is his own, and believe me, we're not just saying this. They have done a great job. That's a great job.
owned by Big Lee Broadcasting. It's been great here at the Fox Theater, 9 till the hour.
I'm Deanne Dierdorf.
Yeah.
And on the phone now, live from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, is our old friend Mark. Good morning, Mark.
Hi, man. You have no idea how great it is to actually be talking to you live in person after spending the last 2 weeks with the Best of Imus. Not that the Best of Imus isn't brilliant, especially the fact that there's two versions, the radio and the MSNBC, so it's like an embarrassment of riches. It's like the certs of radio, because it's two Imus in the mornings in one. It's quite comforting, really. Almost makes me feel normal. I mean, as normal as a person can get who eats Prozac like they were Pez.
Yeah.
I actually have a little Pez dispenser I made in your likeness. Whenever I get to feeling a little jumpy, I just pull back that head of yours and yank it out of the Prozac out of your neck. I don't know if this is a coincidence or what, but I was off for the past 2 weeks myself. Well, technically, I've been off for the past 2 years, ever since the post office gave me that leave of absence after my psychiatric evaluation categorized me as postage due. But I've been using the time wisely. I did some tinkering around in my workshop with some timer devices and stuff, and I finally cataloged my collection of severed heads by ethnic origin and data decapitation. I even made some New Year's resolutions, like I'm going to read A Catcher in the Rye again, because it's almost my favorite book of all time, next to God's Other Son and Two Guys, Four Corners, that is. And, of course, that Whitaker Chambers book, which reminds me, I heard you got one of those Woodstock typewriters from Mrs. Imus for Christmas. Well, imagine that. Aren't you the lucky one? Boy, Santa was good to you. I was looking for one of those for months and months and months and months, ever since you started talking about Alger Hiss for months and months and months and months. I wanted one of those Woodstock typewriters because I think it would be just the perfect thing for me to use to write my manifesto.
Imus!
Copyright 1998, CBS Radio, all rights reserved. Imus in the Morning is a presentation of WFAN, Westwood One Entertainment, and The Devil.
This concludes the entertainment and revenue-generating portion of your broadcast day. We now return you to the rest of your local programming schedule, an indecipherable embarrassment of broadcasting incompetence that compelled the station to subscribe to the Imus in the Morning program in the first place. The entertainment and revenue-generating portion of the broadcast day, the Imus in the Morning program, will resume Monday morning. Check your local listings for time and schedule. Scores and sports news. It's WFAN 2020 Sports at the top of the hour, 20.